Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome back. Hope you're having an absolutely fantastic day. Some games are just awesome and too good to mess around with. So for today, the question is, how did he achieve a result like this? Just an absolutely epic result, and without any shenanigans or funniness, in all seriousness, let's just enjoy this game and see how he did it. He is top tier here on Campin' a Bushka map. Encounter mode. One team spawns in the north, one team spawns in the south. There is a white circle on the map, which is the encounter circle, the base, which is very hard to capture. I think it takes like 4 minutes with one person in it. He's in an Object 268 version 4, that Russian behemoth, heavily armored TD. His name is Avochta BWS from the RD1 clan. Shout out to you guys! And when he started this game, he did not know that he was going to have just an absolutely, incredibly amazing game. And the enemies are moving full force. It looks like they're working together. The enemies are no slouches here, guys. They're working coordinated. They're moving down. They've decided we're going to take the 1-2-3 line. We're just going to go and heavily assault the 1-2-3 line and take everyone out and then sweep around, get them surrounded, and end this game in a couple of minutes. And they have an Object 268 version 4 who he bounced on. Can he hit? Where does he shoot him? Oh, he went underneath. And his teammate, the Jagdpanzer 100, is not... Well, is he shooting HE or what's going on? The two Object 268 version 4s, they're getting shot on the side now. They've bounced on him. He's wondering, where do I shoot myself? There you go. He needs... What is his Jagdpanzer doing? He doesn't want to... He's just exploding because his teammates are Muppets. And you can see what's going to happen here, guys. It's 2 versus 1. The same tank. Can he? Boom! He takes one of them out. Does he get any help from his friends? He's got an E-100 beside him. Come on, E-100. Oh, the artillery stuns him. He angles his armor. And he's behind topography, so the other enemies can't shoot him. And boom! He takes him out. And the two Object 268 version 4s. How do you feel now? Only two people are dead so far on your team. And who are they? You! Your plan was thwarted. Thwarted by this mighty, who played it perfectly. He bounced the shot. He missed the shot. He did not get good RNG. He didn't get a lot of help. He did get some help, but not a lot of help from his teammates. I would have thought that Jagdpanzer E-100 would have planted at least one shot of 1,000 HP into the side of one of those guys, but I think his artillery helped, and I'm sure this E-100 helped. And now he's in the bush. He's push in the bush. But it ain't over, okay? It ain't over. They're gonna be losing. Because if you look at the minimap here, you'll notice that the enemy team has taken full map control. They've got pretty much the whole... Well, they don't have the hill. But they're fighting it out on the hill. His team is on the hill, but I think they're exposed up there. They got one of their tanks in the cap, wasting his time. Being in the cap kind of takes you out of the battle and just makes you a target. Because it just takes too long to cap. And that's a big gun, the T-30. The T-30 could be hull down somewhere, actually participating in the battle, but he's in the cap. Maybe he's close to the edge where he can try and shoot people, but it's just not a good position. Oh, beautiful. Overmatch! Oh, but this guy is just churning up the damage. Now, 5,000 damage, and now he's got stealth on his side. He's kind of hull down because there's topography here.
Yes, Pravitsia.
But it's still not a runaway. They're losing by 4,287 HP, guys. They're really losing. And it looks like they might win the hill, which is kind of like the only thing they have now. And Wargaming decided that he should miss that shot because they're losing 4-5. And the game's already lasted 4 minutes, which is more than Wargaming's target of how long games should last. Come on, Wargaming. How could he have missed that shot? Your RNG sometimes is not, is rigged. It's rigged NG. Rig number generator. Was it a ghost shell? Did it deviate? Who knows, right? It looked to me like it should have hit.
But the Wargaming said no.
Alright. It's an Object 260. And an object 25 says, a lot of objects here, guys, but he's an object himself.
Yeah, уничтожено.
It's hard to pick a side when it's an object versus an object. There's a lot of objects in this game, and 1, 2, 3 of them are dead on the enemy team, and one of them is already dead on his team. Okay, well, let's take it easy now. Take it easy. And luckily, the guys on the hill have managed to keep the hill. And the T-30, who's in the cap, types in chat, camper, go. He's berating someone on his team and calling them a camper, even though he sat in the base for this whole game. He went to the base and sat there and died, and now he posted in chat to his teammate, camper, go fight. We lose because of you. You are camper, you should go. I sat in base for 4 minutes and died, but you are camper, you should go. I don't know if he's referring to this object, who I guess if you looked at the minimap, you might think, oh, he's camping there at A2. But he's not camping. He's been shooting his gun all game. He stopped the onslaught from the enemies from encircling this team. And the only reason this game is still going, well, there's two reasons, is him. He kept this flank alive, and I guess his teammates that are fighting on the hill have kept the other flank alive. So there's he has done a fantastic job, and his two teammates on the hill, who are they? I don't see their names. It is the Charfateur, and the other guy died. So it's just the Charfateur left on the hill, but he had another person with him who did really well. And now, can he make the shot? Come on, can he? Boom. R and G. R being the operative word. Random, I guess, is the real word. So much freaking. Just when you need it, you know? It's a close game. You're losing 8-9. The spread is 2,007. If you make that shot, you'd lower the spread to about 2,000. That guy backs off. Very important shot. Randomly missed. Okay. Do not caps is object 264. It's useless. True. The T-30 sat in cap. It was useless. The Charfateur in cap. Look at the counter. It's over 3 minutes. 301, 3. It's counting down from 3 minutes. I believe it's counting 1 second per click. Sometimes these counters say, like when there's three people in it, the numbers are the same, but it counts down faster, so it's not 1 click per second. But I believe when there's only one person on encounter, is it 3 or 4 minutes? It's a lot. You can't cap. The enemies will, they have an artillery as well. Someone just has to spot them. Artillery resets. Plus, it takes you out of the game. Like that Charfateur did so well winning the hill. Why waste your time? Why waste your time in the cap now, Charfateur? You're not going to win by capping. And as when you get spotted, you're going to be dead. So not good. Not good. But you've got to play the hand you're dealt. And he just told his teammate, why push? We're losing. It's always lost, says the Object 277. No, it's not always lost. His teammate in the Object 277 pushed forward and died like a Muppet. And this guy said, why did you push and throw away your tank? And the Object 277 said, it's always lost. He's already given up because the game has lasted 6 minutes. And he has the attention span of a gnat. And he's like, you can't play for more than 3 minutes without getting bored and surging forward and throwing his tank away. Now, the Charfateur left the cap, which was smart. Maybe he was just baiting the enemies to come to the cap. That's possible. But it was a risk. And now this guy's got to decide whether he stays back here or whether he tries to move up. He's safe if he stays back there. And if he moves up and the Foch 155, the Cobra, and the 257 spot him, that is not good. He does not have a lot of backup. He has a camping E-100, an E-100 that's still at A-3, which is a little, that's not a very good position for an E-100. But he does move forward. He does move forward, and maybe, they are losing, but, oh, and he spotted. This is what I thought was a bad idea, and boom, he bounced the Foch, and he did not spot the Foch, and the Fosh is going to reload and take another shot, and the Fosh missed because it's a Fosh, and he decides, okay, if I'm spotted, I might as well, okay, that's who spotted me, might as well move forward. And this was a very risky maneuver, but boom, is the E-100, and someone else shot him. I think the E-100 got a good shot on him. He got some spotting assist. He's up to 2,969 spotting assist. And there's the Fosh. There he is, reloading like a Fosh. Boom. And that was the smartest move he could have made. He made a mistake moving up, I think. But on the other hand, he did decide to move up, and he knew what to do. When he got spotted and he was getting shot, rather than just back up and die, he said, well, if I'm going to die, I need to surge forward and at least spot who is shooting me so my teammates can take some shots. And he surged forward, and the E-100 helped him, and the artillery helped him, and he was able to help himself, and they cleared the 1-2 line. And the Cobra is nowhere to be found. The Cobra obviously moved. So it ended up being, he took a gamble, right? He took a risk, a calculated risk, and it ended up being the right decision. Because he could have sat there at the whole game and waited and let the time run out. But now they've got control of a lot more map. Now they're free to move around. And you notice the E-100 is also moving around. So give him credit. No, he just played safe. And does he have a shot there? He's found the artillery. You notice how he checked if he has a shot with the central marker without waving his controls around? And now he can take out the artillery, which really is going to make it a little... Oh, and he took a hit from the Cobra. And he took another hit from the Cobra. Oh, and he did not take another hit. The Cobra has more shots than that. Did he get under the Cobra's... The Cobra's up on the hill, obviously. On the hill, he types in chat. Cobra two shells out. There you go. He's told his teammate. The Cobra has more than two shells. Maybe he lost... the guy went underneath topography and the Cobra couldn't shoot. Or maybe, you know, we don't know. He's got a Char Fatour now who is going to spot the hill. The Char Fatour did a good job too. He won the hill. Then he went in the cap. Then he retreated and maintained all his HP. So the Char knew what he was doing. He was trying to bait people by capping. But now the Char is moving towards the hill. If he can spot the hill, he's got an E-100 and an Object 268 version 4 ready to shoot, right? So this guy, how did he achieve the result he achieved? He's got some good teammates. The Char, the E-100, and the other guy that held the hill with the Char originally, but he died, I think also did a good job. And boom! It was an object, so you know, he hit the object, bounced. I think the E-100 hit the object, bounced. And artillery hit the object and did zero damage. Because it's an object. Maybe his screen was hit. So he's going to decide now, is the Char Fatour going to respot him? Now the object should know he's in a crossfire. E-100 cap, he says. Perhaps cap, there's not enough time. Even if he caps, there's not enough time. He put question mark there. I don't think that's a good enough thing to do. Maybe if they both cap, do they have enough time? I do not believe they have enough time. But he's going to go. He's saying, he's asking the E-100 to join him. Let's see, 3 minutes. There's not enough time. Well, he's taking his time. He's just moving along. Okay, the Char spotted the Cobra, and he takes a big shot into the Cobra. The object is going to try and kill the Char now. The object's cantilevered over the hill. And they killed the Char, which were their eyes. Boom! And he missed because that's just the way it works. And they do have enough time to cap. You notice the counter is going down faster. They're at 110, 109. It's going faster than one side. This is what I was saying. He takes a good shot on the object. When there's two people in the cap, you see it's going faster than one increment per second. Can you take another shot? It is. Look at it. 54-3, 52-51. Okay. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong about that. It seems to me like it is. Char. Char. No, it's going. It's going 1 per second. I was wrong. Oh, but now they have no time because they've been reset. They can't cap anymore. Forget about what I was saying. Capping is not an option. He's got to make it count now. Boom. Okay, he's face hugging him. The Cobra is unloading, and he's only doing 90 damage per shot or so. The object bounces. The E100, take a shot, E100. The Cobra's on a reload. Take out the Cobra. Yes, he's taking out the Cobra. There's 20 seconds left. He needs the E100 to take a shot. The E100 plants a shot into the object. Can he make the artillery hits him. He's stunned. He's stunned. Can he do it? Can he do it? Aim. Yes! That was worth watching, wasn't it? And that's how you achieve a result like this. With some good teammates, the E100 actually really came through. And so did the Char. Where is the Char? Right here. He came through. He ends up with a 1500 spotting assist when it counted. He's got 8 kills, over 11,000 damage, and, you know, he lost some credits because it was too much fun to make credits in that game. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed that. Leave some comments. How do you think he played that battle? I thought it was a great battle. I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel. Help the channel keep growing, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.